嗨，各位，我今天看 YouTube 的人说，这是 L Max， 这是波的 Mute， 跟他的宝不太一样，还是处于一个钝到不行的程度。我用磨刀石特别把它打钝，钝过了。那有人说很难磨，那我们就来试看看吧。这是便宜的钻石磨刀石，太钝了，好吧，送四把还要开始，本来想说直上一千的。这个是一般五金行就买得到的钻石磨刀板，我是觉得还蛮好用的啦。我请务必加水磨。这个好处就是非常快，当然如果你角度没抓好，配的也很快。锅先试看一下 ，OK 啦。感觉另外一头有毛边的。后段没磨到，再一次，前面毛边出来，
It's for me?
Yes.
Mangio mia tortellini.
Ciao.
It can take several months before a new product is ready for mass production. And only one in three make it that far. But once it does, a huge customer base awaits. We spend over £5 billion a year on pizza, pasta, and other favorites. Ruth has been finding out where our passion for Italian food started.
According to the latest figures, there are 4,735 Italian restaurants currently operating in Britain. But just post-war, there were only a handful. So how did we fall in love with Italian food? Well, it all began here, in London's Soho. In the late 1940s, London's Italian community moved into Soho, centering around Frith Street. The Paledru family set up their cafe, Bar Italia, in 1949. Grandson Antonio runs it today. Wow, has it changed much at all?
Well, since it was opened in 1949, nothing changed really.
How's that?
Very little has changed. The format is still as it was. The coffee machine is virtually still as it was. My grandparents came from Italy. They saw an opportunity for good coffee, but also as a social centre in the heart of Soho, which was predominantly Italians in the time.
So it was a really Italian area.
Massive.
So.
It was called Little Italy.
There were 15,000 Italians living in London in 1951. Many working in the West End as waiters in French restaurants. But in the 1960s, they started to open up their own relaxed Italian trattoria-style eateries.
No one could do it.
This is the Soho Directory for 1958, and you can see there's quite a lot of Italian restaurants being listed. In fact, there were a total of 13 in just five streets. And in here it says, the 50-year-old family restaurant with a reputation for excellent Italian food and a charming tradition of preserving class ladies at dinner. Most of the original restaurants have long gone. But there is one restaurant that not only survived and thrived, but became the first of the mass market Italian restaurant chain. Spaghetti House in Gouge Street opened its doors in September 1955. Luigi Lavarini, the son of one of the original owners, runs the restaurant chain today. How did the Spaghetti House come about?
My father and my uncle met in Bar Italia and came up with the name Spaghetti House.
How old were you when the restaurant opened?
I was 6 months old.
Oh, I was there.
As a child, I remember always an exciting, buzzing atmosphere in the restaurant.
What was it?
People would eat close together on small tables. There would be queues outside.
And what sort of food was being served back in 1955?
If we look here.
Is this your early menu?
This goes right back to the beginning.
Spag bol might not have been an authentic Italian dish, but it was what British people wanted to see on the menu.
They felt transported to Italy.
我没有遇到那种薄片碎裂的问题，要么就是有加水有
差，
要么就是人品。
Even glamorous.
It's fiddly, isn't it? I've tried a
sophisticated
thing to know how to do it. This is the CP 值最高，不到1000块。我记得单买这块板子好像才700块，400+1000号，哦，很好用。
Affordable food and friendly hospitality was a winning combination that taught us to enjoy eating out.
适度的润滑很重要的。我跟其他磨刀石比起来，它确实有一种啪啪啪的声音，听起来很像玻璃破掉。你在？但是没有像影片中。吹角的状况，太好。以前好，我的习惯，这种像这种石头，因为会有 loading， 所以不用。趁它还新鲜的时候，赶快把它清洗，要不然等它卡到石缝里面，这块石头的好处就跑掉了。第二块。接下来再来一块。3000，刚才是1000，再来一个3000。这个，这是水啊，反正这个只要均匀薄薄一层就好，所以用喷雾也比较好。这样应该就可以了，还是有漏底，好，不管，再来。同样的石头，这只是6000号。 有选号。一万两千号，这时候蛮便宜的，效果也还不错。推荐给我想就跟就是一束大花的感觉。没有到，其实也没什么两边。嗯，我要那纸。Eventually， 皮革。钻石膏，你要用清图也可以，不过用过钻石膏之后就回不去了。切纸没什么，切纸膏吧。This program is also available.